हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी विथ यस्टरडेज मैनी स्टूडेंट्स रिस्पॉन्स ऑन द वीडियो एंड थैंक यू सो मच स्टूडेंट्स फॉर मोटिवेटिंग मी एक्चुअली टू डू समथिंग बेटर फॉर यू. विथ द सेम स्पिरिट आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट टूडेज टॉपिक दैट इज बैटल ऑफ प्लासी. नाउ हियर वी रिक्वायर्ड टू डिस्कस टू बैटल. ओके, द फर्स्ट वन इज Battle of Plassey and the next one is Battle of Buxar. Now the most critical part is there are so many students in my career I noticed that if the question asked about Battle of Buxar, some students make mistake. They wrote the answer that is Battle of Plassey, and when it is asked Battle of Plassey, they change and write Battle of Buxar. So please don't do that. And other thing is what they are little bit interdependent, so that is why chances of misunderstanding is possible in exam. So my request to you is just focus. We will discuss term by term. Siraj ud Daulah was ruling over Bengal. Okay, so this is Siraj ud Daulah. I hope you can see. Okay, Siraj ud Daulah. Okay, and he is ruling on West Bengal. Okay, next sentence. Due to his impulsive nature, he had some opponents in his state. Now impulsive means what? See, impulsive means the meaning of impulsive is showing the behavior in which you do suddenly without any planning and without considering the effects. That means what? Impulsive means you are doing something without predicting the result. Thoughtless action, we should say. So here what happened? Because of Siraj ud Daulah's impulsive nature, he had many opponent. Opponent means what? Opponent means the people who oppose him. Okay. Or we can say many people who are not agree, enemies you can say. So he had some enemies in his state. During this period, British East India Company built a fortress around the trade center in Calcutta on pretext of security reason. Pretext means what? Under the reason. Pretext means under the reason of security issue, but without taking the permission of Nawab. Okay. So here what happened? See, we'll discuss. Suppose this is the trade center of Britishers. Okay, and under the reason of security, the British East India Company prepared the fortress. Fort, I hope you understand. So they prepared fortress. Clear? But problem is not that they prepared this, but problem is they not talk with Siraj ud Daulah. And as I already talked to you, Siraj ud Daulah is impulsive nature. So common sense. They not took the permission of Nawab. They prepared the fortress around the trade center. But Nawab Siraj ud Daulah destroyed the fortress. Imagine, see. As because of impulsive nature, Siraj ud Daulah destroyed this area. Okay, I mean to say, destroy this fortress. Okay. But Nawab Siraj ud Daulah destroyed the fortress. Now when this news reached to Madras, okay, since because indirectly Siraj ud Daulah opposed Britishers. So when this news reached to Madras, that is Chennai, a small army of company led by Robert Clive reached Bengal in order to help the Kolkata trade center, because now Kolkata trade center is in danger because they built the fortress but that is destroyed. So now Britishers are frightened. The news reached to Madras and Robert Clive decide, okay, to arrive Calcutta, okay, with a small army. Here we have a Mr. Robert Clive. So this Robert Clive with a small army of the company reach Bengal. Purpose is what? To help the Kolkata trade center, because as I explained to you, Kolkata trade center is now under pressure, under tension. In spite of Army of East India Company being strong, they realized that it was not easy to defeat Nawab's army. See, Nawab's army is not that easy. In spite of East India Company is very strong as far as soldiers, weapons concerned, but yet it is not easy to defeat Nawab's army. That they understood, that they observed, that they realized that it is not easy to defeat Nawab, even though we have a strong army yet. So now Robert Clive resorted to treachery. Now, treachery means what? See, treachery means fraud. Okay, which type of fraud? A treachery is someone you thought was your friend who share your secret with everyone. That means what? A fellow who go fraud with you. So under that treachery, okay, Robert Clive prepared, restored means prepare to a treachery, one scheme, a conspiracy. Now conspiracy means secret plan. Okay, conspiracy means secret plan. Okay, so here Robert Clive go for conspiracy secret plan in order to defeat the Nawab, in which Robert Clive talked to Nawab's command-in-chief, the main officer of army, commander-in-chief Mir Jafar, and Seth Amin Chand were coax request to join Robert Clive. So here what happened? Robert Clive communicate with Mir Jafar and Seth Amin Chand that you do one thing, you join with us. We are Britishers. If you join with us, we will give you some benefit. Clear? So this offer provide to Mir Jafar and Seth Amin Chand to join Robert Clive and British East India Company. On the pretext of that, the Nawab unnecessary, on the pretext means what? Under the reason that Nawab is unnecessary harassing the people, a war was declared at the ground near a village named Plassey. So now Robert Clive is very clever fellow. Okay, Robert Clive was very clever fellow, and Robert Clive already talked to Mir Jafar and Seth Amin Chand that both of them require to be Robert Clive's side and other side Nawab alone. Under that assurance, Robert Clive announced that Nawab is ruling, that is true, but people are not happy with Nawab. Nawab is unnecessary harassing people. So that's not okay. We want to fight with Nawab. We can't tolerate this nonsense. How people can be harassed? With this situation, British East India Company, under the leadership of Lord Clive, Robert Clive, they decide to fight. Okay. Battle, war was declared. War was declared near the village named Plassey. Yeah. So the war is occurred in the ground, and the ground is near the village Plassey. Important points. The Battle of Plassey was fought on 23rd June 1757 AD. The Battle of Plassey is situated 38 km from Murshidabad, that is West Bengal. Okay, Murshidabad is a place. From that place, 38 km away, the battlefield available where they fought. Now, according to the Robert Clive's plan, Mir Jafar lost the battle because they already decided. They already apply treachery, and then they decide that this war required to be lost. Okay, so Mir Jafar, okay, according to the plan, lost the battle. Siraj ud Daulah was defeated. It is but necessary because their best people are with Robert Clive. So Siraj ud Daulah was defeated, and due to Robert Clive's treachery, the scheme, the Battle of Plassey ended in just half a day. Imagine, students. Here it says that it is difficult to defeat Nawab's army. And here, because of inactive way of fighting, okay, and because of the Mir Jafar's inactive participation, Siraj ud Daulah defeated, and the battle is just complete in half a day. And the result of the battle is what? The result of the battle is, the company, as a result, got a freehold. Now freehold means what? Freehold means ownership of property. Okay. So he got, this British East India Company got freehold over 24 paranganas. Now paranganas means what? Parangana means a group of village or subdivision of district in India. So group of village. So 24 parangana, group of village, freehold ownership goes to British East India Company. So result of the battle is British East India Company got the control, the ownership of 24 parangana, 24 villages. And Mir Jafar was made the Nawab of Bengal in the place of Sirajuddin. Now the Nawab of Bengal is Mir Jafar. Thus, the foundation of the company rule in India was laid with Battle of Plassey. The foundation has become strong with the help of Battle of Plassey in 1757, because in 1757 Battle of Plassey was called. Okay, so these are the important points. Okay, we will just discuss today only about Battle of Plassey. Battle of Buxar we will discuss afterwards, otherwise you will mix up both. A few questions I would like to ask you, whose answer you have to give me in comments, the challenging question. Okay, I repeat, few questions I am sharing with you, and whose answer you have to write in the comment of this video. I am writing some words and you have to find out the difference between these words. Okay, the first word, that is fight, war, battle. Okay, you have to tell me. You can search Google, you can use Google, you can read book, anything you do, I don't care, I don't mind, but you have to tell me the difference between these words: fight, war, battle. Okay, but answer you have to write in YouTube comments. You are not supposed to write the answer of this question in your homework book or notebook, whatever you say. Okay, I want answer of these three words, difference between these three words. Another question is the difference between Nawab and King. Here, one word is Nawab, other word is King. What is the difference between these two? Again, I am clarifying to you once again the answer of these questions. The first is what? Find out the difference between these three. And second question is find out the difference between these two. But you are supposed to write the answer in comments, not in homework book, not in fair book. Is it clear? Okay, I am waiting for your comments. Your comments are always motivate me to do something better for you. We will end our session over here. Okay, you can write the answers in common book. There is no need to prepare separate book. Even though you prepare, no problem, but now you write in common book. Okay, and we will meet tomorrow with a topic, that is Battle of Buxar. Okay, and in homework PDF, I will provide all these details. So if you wish, you can refer again. Okay, clear? So we'll keep up with this today. Please take care of yourself. Thank you.